minutes to speak. Is that something which you still want to stick to, Sagar, or 5 minutes is more than enough? Thank you very much. In the 5 minutes, what I'm going to be talking about, the first 5 seconds I'll take to thank the organizers. The next 2 minutes I'll spend in introducing myself, and the next 3 minutes after that, I'll spend in talking about TIE, the Indus Entrepreneurs. There's no time for question and answer, so maybe at the bar afterwards, which Sagar, I understand, has organized, we can meet, and I will ask the questions and you will provide the answers. I came to Calcutta, my name is 22 years old, so I'm not from Calcutta, but Calcutta is now my adopted city. I came to Calcutta, as I mentioned, when I was 22 years old. In those days, people used to come to Calcutta to look for jobs, and I was one of them. I joined Tata Steel when I was 22 years old, and within the first year itself, while I was still on training, they transferred me out of Calcutta. They really banished me because I was perceived not to be that head office kind of a guy. And I was kept outside for about 20 years till I came back when I was 42 years old. When they ran out of positions outside Calcutta to transfer me to, and really the only place that I could come to was the headquarters which was here in Calcutta. But by that time, when I was about 38 years old, they made me chief sales manager, and I was the youngest chief sales manager that Tata Steel ever had. So meaning to say, over the years I did something right, I was lucky, and I sort of moved ahead. But when I came back here when I was 42 years old, it was to head a re-engineering exercise which was done for Tata Steel along with various other consultants. So I headed a cross-functional team which re-engineered and redesigned our market-facing processes, which then was built into an SAP implementation. And at that point of time, it was the largest SAP implementation that India had ever seen. We went live in 40 locations across the country. When I was at the top of my game, I resigned from Tata Steel. So at that point in time, I was 44 years old. To join as the CEO of a startup. Now, startups is something that we all understand today, but in the year 99-2000, it wasn't even a word that was used, or it was coined much later. But that was the time that the internet was happening, the dot-com story was happening, and I was hit by that bug of entrepreneurship. And that's how I resigned from Tata Steel to join this young startup. Of course, Dr. Irani, who was the managing director of Tata Steel, would not have any of it, and he persuaded me to stay on in Tata Steel. Well, not really stay on in Tata Steel, but stay on in the Tata family, and to start the startup within the Tata Group itself. And that was how Metal Junction was created. So though I wanted to be an entrepreneur, I ended up being what is called an intrapreneur. An intrapreneur means that I was the founder, but I was not the promoter. The promoter was Tata Steel, and the president of India through Steel Authority of India. And we made a huge success of this wonderful initiative, this venture, this private-public venture, which was called Metal Junction. And we went on to become India's largest and most profitable e-commerce company. And this happened very quickly. But more important than building the largest and the finest, I think we added a great deal of value to various supply chains in this country, the steel supply chain, the gold supply chain, to mention a few. It was a wonderful journey that I had, which culminated last year when I left M Junction. Since then, I've taken on the role of consultant and entrepreneur. So I'm a consultant where I'm helping startups, once again, because that's what I've done for the last 16 years. That's what gives me happiness and pleasure to scale up. I'm also a consultant to a consultant called Goldrat Consulting, and they've done a lot of work with the retail industry in India as well as across the world. The founder of Goldrat Consulting, Dr. Goldrat himself, or Prahi Goldrat, worked tirelessly in terms of coming up with this theory and then implementing this in various industries and geographies. Retail industry was one industry where Goldrat has done such a tremendous job. How do you actually increase availability while reducing inventory? And I think that for the retail industry is really the key in terms of moving forward towards profitability. They have worked with various organizations here in India, including, I think at this point of time, they're working with Telcom and doing some great stuff there. But besides consultancy, I'm also an entrepreneur. I was just telling Sagar, as well as Basant, that we are going to be launching something in the healthcare space, because I believe the healthcare in India needs a lot of assistance from all of us. So we're going to be launching very quickly in healthcare. Which brings me into this wonderful organization called TIE. TIE stands for the Indus Entrepreneurs. And it has really been set up to look after startups. But let me take you back 25 years in time. Silicon Valley, we have a number of Indians who have gone to Silicon Valley, who've done some great business over there, and they have succeeded. And after having succeeded, they decide to give back. And what best way can they give back is to give back to others who follow them in terms of helping them to scale up their operations. To help them to not make the same mistakes or not go through the same trials and tribulations that they did, but to ease their entry into becoming entrepreneurs. So that really was the foundation of TIE in Silicon Valley 25 years ago. And of course they got it right because there was a palpable need as far as this was concerned, and they were able to satiate this need very, very effectively. So really TIE is made up of two wings. One are what is called the charter members. The charter members are the guys who, so to say, have succeeded, who have done well, and who now want to give back. And on the other side, we've got the associate members, and these associate members are the young guys, maybe some a little older than the young guys, but who want to start up ventures. And those ventures are a little risky, and hence they need whatever assistance that is required. These are innovative ventures, these are entrepreneurial ventures. So really, TIE provides that bridge, that platform, to bring the two together so that the guys who want to give are able to give to the guys who actually need it. And we have had some tremendous success across the world in this. So TIE is now a global organization. It works through city chapters, and today there are over 60 city chapters. The first one, as I mentioned, was in Silicon Valley. Today there are over 30 in the United States itself, United States including Canada, and another 30 outside, of which about 10 are in India, and the other 20 are spread across the world. The members are not only Indians like you and I, but also from other nationalities who have joined this wonderful movement. In Calcutta, TIE Kolkata was launched 15 years ago, and we've done some great stuff in Calcutta. You will hear from some of our charter members later in the day. We have Vasant here, who was a past president. We have Hari Balasubramanian, who will be coming in and also talking to you. Both of them charter members, in terms of what we have been able to achieve. But more than that, we have Sagar, who is a product of TIE. It was at a TIE-Con, at an event such like this, which is organized by TIE, where he made a presentation which was much appreciated by some other charter members who came in, who were not from Canada, who were coming from outside, and they much liked it, and that's how he got a lot of his funding. And of course, he never looked back after that. So, Sagar is one shiny example of what TIE has been able to do as far as the startup industry, as the startup ecosystem is concerned. So really what we offer to you, as I mentioned, if you are guys who have made it, come join us. We will give you an opportunity for you to share your resources, your knowledge, your learnings, your money with others who actually need this, so that you can then participate and help them in their journey and take the risk that they move forward with it, so that you can participate both in the failures as well as the rewards of these young startups. I will stop there, and as I mentioned, that there is no question answer session which is planned for now, but I'm in the ground and I will be with you for the next number of hours. And in case any of you have any questions that I can answer, as far as TIE is concerned, I would be happy to do so. I wish you this session, RAI, the very best of success. I understand this is the first time you're organizing this in the Eastern region. I came across RAI in the corridors of power, which is in Delhi, the Ministry of Commerce. I was representing the online retailers as the chairman of the National Committee on E-Commerce of CII, and we had the RAI on the other side, represented by some of your leaders, your office bearers, representing the other side. It was a lively discussion, and I look forward to more such lively discussions. Thank you very much.